Hello students, I hope all are keeping fine. Today I am going to continue the topic properties of multiplication of integers. Already I have discussed in last class three more properties. First was closure property, second commutative property, and third associative property. Today I am going to discuss multiplicative identity. What is multiplicative identity? So I will say that one is the multiplicative identity. Why you can say that one is the multiplicative identity? Because we know that in one, if you multiply any integers, that integer itself will get. It means if one is a multiplicative identity, I am saying it means you will multiply it with any integer, that is suppose 2, then you will get 2. For example, suppose minus you want to take, so 1 into minus 6, it means minus. Means that integer will get. Means that number will get which is multiplied with 1. Is it clear? So here I am going to write if a is an integer and 1 is multiplicative identity, then A O 1 equal to 1 O A equal to A for all A belongs to integer. Set of integer. Clear? What is O? Already you know that O is an operation, and what is the operation is here? The operation multiplication is going on. Here, which operation is going on? Multiplication here. So this is the statement of multiplicative identity. So you can see here, for example, you can take if a equal to 2, 3, 4, anything you can take, no problem, 7 suppose, and operation is multiplication. So what is LHS? LHS equal to AO1, it means A means what? 7, O means multiplication, and 1 is identity, we are saying, then the value is 7. Is it clear? Here I am taking with example A equal to 7, and O, already you know that operation, which operation is going on? Multiplication. So O is multiplication, and we will put the value is here in this statement. LHS you can take LHS AO1, it means A equal to 7, O means operation, it means multiplication, and what is 1? 1 is the identity, we are saying this is called multiplicative identity. Then what is the product of 7 into 1? You will get the same integer, means 7. Now what is RHS? RHS you can see 1OA, it means 1, what is O? O means operation, multiplication. And A means 7, its value equal to 7. Then you say that LHS equal to RHS. What you can say? LHS equal to RHS. It means that is O1 is called multiplicative identity. Is it clear? This is the multiplicative identity. It means, is it, anybody will ask, what is multiplicative identity? So you can say that multiplicative identity is 1. Why it is 1? If you multiply any number, that number you will get, means number will not change after multiplication. So you can say that 1 is multiplicative identity. And what is additive identity? In previous classes, means 6th class, your teacher has explained and you have studied about additive identity, the additive identity is zero. Because in zero, any number you will add, then you can say that zero is a additive identity for addition. Now, next property is fifth one is multiplicative inverse. Actually, this property is not given, so but I am explaining. Multiplicative inverse. What is multiplicative inverse? Any number you will consider, suppose the number is A, and what number you will multiply with A, means which number you will multiply with A, we should get identity, multiplicative identity. So you know that in A, if you will multiply its reciprocal 1 by A, then what you will get, this will be cancelled and you will get identity. It means multiplicative identity. Is it clear? Actually, this topic is not given, that's why I do not want to explain, but you remember this. If any number, suppose any integer is given, suppose 7, and what will be the multiplicative inverse of 7? So you will say that the multiplicative inverse of 7 is equal to 1 by 7. Remember this. Means the reciprocal of a number, reciprocal of an integer is the multiplicative inverse of given number. Is it clear? So no need to explain, it is not given, but you remember this, the reciprocal of an integer is the multiplicative inverse. Remember this. So next property, the product of zero. Sixth one we can take, or you can say that this is sixth one, and product of zero. What is zero? You know that zero is an integer. Zero is an integer, neither negative nor positive. Only one number is that in set of integer, neither negative nor positive. But if you will multiply with zero by any other integer, then what will be the result? So you can see that the result will be always zero. So if A is an integer, then A O 0 equal to 0 O A is always 0. Remember this case. The product of any integer with 0 is always 0. For example, you can consider if A equal to minus 10. And what is your operation? Operation equal to multiplication. Then LHS you can take. What is LHS? Minus 10 O. Sorry. A O 0. It means that A is minus 10. What is O? O means operation multiplication. And what is this? This is 0. And product of any integer with 0 is always 0. What is RHS? RHS you can see 0, O and A will equal to 0 into, means O means operation multiplication, into minus 10. Its value will be equal to again 0. In both case, we are seeing that what LHS equal to RHS. Then we will say what we can say. We can say that the product of zero with any integer is always zero. This is the zero product or product of zero. It's a very important this topic, means this property, distributive property. Distributive property. What is distributive property? There are two types of the distributive. One is the left distributive and another is right distributive. Actually here only one part is given, but I will write the statement of distributive property. There are two types. So you can see here, if A, B and C are three integer, then actually the distributive property not only multiplication, the multiplication over addition. Multiplication over addition. It means that we can say that the first part AO B plus C. Actually, that's why I was using the operation here. Which operation is going on? Multiplication. Here the addition include in this property. So this property you can say multiplication over addition. So we can say here what? You will write AOB plus AOC. AOC. Will not write BOA. Will not write COA. We cannot write. It means A multiply with B means the A will distribute with B and C separately. That's why it is called the distributive. It means the A is distributing with B and C. That's why it is called the distributive. And second part is here, B plus C O A. It means you can write B O A plus C O A. C O A. So you are seeing that A multiplied from left to right. And here A you can say right to left. That's why it is called. Here you can take the negative sign also. Then what will be the distributive property? The distributive property multiplication over subtraction. So here the sign can change. No problem, can take for the negative sign also. Process will be same, no problem. So for example, the first part I am taking here, if A equal to 2, B equal to 1 and C equal to 3 suppose, then I am taking the first part, but LHS is given what? AO B plus C. And what is operation? You know that operation is equal to multiplication, remember this. Multiplication. So what is A to O means multiplication, B plus C means 1 plus 3, so 2 into, first we will add 1 plus 3 equal to 4, its value equal to 4 to the 8, it means LHS equal to 8. What will be the RHS? RHS you can see here, what is RHS? AOB plus this one, AOB plus AOC. Actually, you know that the commutative law, AOB equal to BOA, result will same. But here in distributive property, we cannot write BOA, always write, because here A will multiply with B, not B will multiply with A. So we will write like this. Now, we can see here, what is A equal to 2, what is operation, is multiplication, you can see here,
clear? Operation is multiplication. 2 into b. B is what? 1 plus a. What is a? A is 2. And what is o? O is an operation, that is multiplication. And what is c? C equal to 3. Then what you can see? 2 into 1. 2 plus 2 into 3. 2, 3 are 6. And its value equal to 8. Then what is LHS? LHS equal to 8. What is RHS? RHS equal to 8. And then what you can say? We can say here LHS equal to RHS. It means that the distributive property of multiplication, distributive property of multiplication over addition is true for what? For integers. For integers. This is a distributive property. All property is over, which is given in your book. You have to learn all the property and practice it. In next class, I shall start the exercise 1.2. I hope already you have completed 1.1. So in next class, I will start 1.2.